this is Vivi here. Thank you so much for stopping by my channel. Today, I will make another recipe from the game Genshin Impact. And this is a gift that little Pai Mom prepared for Miss Ningguang. And this is a sugar frost slime. I will use the very simple trick that you always see in molecular gastronomy. And I hope Ningguang will like the result. All right, let's start. This sugar frost slime is a gift that Paimon and Traveler specially made for visiting Ningguang. The method I'll be using is called reverse spherification. It's a method used to make popping boba in milk tea or the artificial carvia from where we heard of molecular gastronomy. The slime in game is blue. I immediately thought of using butterfly pea flower to bring the blue color. Butterfly pea is the natural food coloring often used in Southeast Asia. It could change color according to different pH. Usually, we put lemon juice or soda to make it purple. I'm using a tea bag and it's powder inside. It works very fast when brewed in hot water. The butterfly pea has a herbal flower tea scent, just like other flower teas. Thin the butterfly pea tea with some water until you are satisfied with the color. Add tiny bit edible glitter to make it look dreamy. You don't have to. Add some sugar or alcohol or flavored syrup to make it tasty. Here comes the secret ingredient. You'll need to add 1% liquid weight calcium lactate. According to some recipes I found, people will use as much as 2%, so I got a middle and used 8 grams of calcium lactate for 500 ml liquid. But maybe my digital skill is not very precise, so I might have used too much calcium lactate, so it cannot fully dissolve. Or it react with the butterfly tea or with the glitter. So it's forming some kind of lumps. You could use a blender here for help, but I think the lumps rather bring a feel of the slime, which I like. So I keep it like this. Then pour the liquid into ice mode to freeze it until solid. Now let's prepare the sodium alginate bath, which will react with the calcium ice ball and form a gel skin that will hold the drink. According to the instruction, we'll need to add a 0.5 to 1% weight of the water. I'm using about 700 to 800 ml water, so 7 grams of sodium alginate here. You must use an electric blender here. It will become very thick. Leave it for an hour or so until the bubbles disappear. Now, let the magic begin. Throw the ice ball in, constantly pour the sodium alginate liquid on top to cover it all. You can clearly see there is a gel skin forming thicker and thicker. It's so interesting. Since my ice ball is pretty big, I leave it for at least 2 minutes to make sure the gel skin could be thick enough to hold the liquid inside. The gel skin is flexible, but I would like to make it thick enough just in case. Use a slotted spoon that big enough to move the ice ball to a bowl of clean water. You have to work fast but gentle at the same time, so the gel won't stick to the spoon or break. Keep the ice ball in water or transfer it to a container to melt. Sprinkle some sugar powder and that's it, sugar frost slime. Next is our taste testing part. Although it looks so nice, but when I was making it, it has some weird unknown chemical reactions. I'm not sure if I should eat it. Well, I think I got a brilliant idea.
How did you make it?
Ta-da-da!
Wow, that looks
pretty so nice, fancy. Right?
Wow. What's inside, actually? Is that edible?
So, every ingredient I put inside is edible.
Okay. I guess. Okay.
Let's start.
Oh, trouble. Whoa.
I think we should consider you. This is edible first, and we're now talking about how to eat it. Should we think about if it is edible?
I mean, I'm gonna try it anyway, so. Cheers.
Cheers.
Yes, it's water.
Mm-hmm. 干了这杯酒 没有酒 Since I made the gel skin pretty thick in case it could be strong enough to hold the drink inside, it's chewy in a weird way. It doesn't have any taste, maybe a little salty. It is supposed to have a texture similar to RØDE. If you make the ice cubes smaller, it'll be easier to handle. You could even use squared ice cubes. It will also work nicely. And the bath is shorter, so the gel skin could be thinner and will taste better and taste more like the popping boba. After all, it's a very interesting experience. I could taste the sweetness from the powdered sugar, the chewiness from the gel membrane, and a water bomb in the mouth. I think it'll be better if I put some other juice or some alcohol inside it. It should be taste better. But I don't think that Ningguang will ever eat any food from anyone that gave to her.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, in case poisoning. So what's important is it looks nice. Alright, that's it for today's video. If you want to see me making other food from Genshin Impact or see me making other food from other games, please comment below, let me know. Alright, if you like my video or my channel, please consider giving me a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys soon in my future videos. Bye!